Hi, welcome back to my channel. Today I decided to film a day early. It's Thursday, it's sunny, and I thought I'd take advantage of being able to film on the floor in front of our front door, which is over there. I thought I would do a flip through of what I've done for the month of March. I apologize for not uploading anything for the past 2 weeks. I will have chapters down below in case you want to skip this, but Bruce has been sick, well, as well as my mom. My mom fell in October, so you know, we were dealing with that, and then Bruce got sick in December. You know, we were dealing with his ear infections, and then it became a skin issue in about January, mid-January. About 2-3 weeks ago, they did some tests and discover that he might have cancer, which was confirmed about 2 weeks ago, which is right about the time I dropped off. So now we're a couple of days into his first treatment. The oncologist thinks that he has a good shot in putting his cancer into clinical remission, which is different, I guess, than human cancer in the sense of trying to put it into remission. It's a club you don't want to be in. But we see the oncologist again next week to evaluate how his first round of treatments are going. I'm going to insert a clip of Bruce in case you'd like to see him. I just took a little clip of him napping on the couch, so I will insert that here. I just want to say thank you for giving us the time for me to not upload. This is my A6 Hobonichi. I use this as a diary. The monthly layouts I use as a gratitude, so I just wanted to show you what I've done. And this is going to be a real-time look of my planners. I didn't do much in my A5 Cousin in the sense of the weekly layout, but this will be photo heavy with Bruce. And then this is my A5 HON that I have inside the, is it called? I forgot the name of it now. Like the sunny logbook or something like that. So let me show you first the A6. And again, I will have chapters down below. So this is what March looks like for me. I did start up again this past Sunday when we saw my mom. And then we started Bruce's treatment, which is when we actually saw his second oncologist, which is an oncologist closer to where we live. And so I started up again trying to stay positive. I didn't do, see, today's Thursday, so I will do one again tonight. But so this is what March looks like. Here's February and January. And ideally, this is going to be like a gratitude highlight of the day. I just didn't see anything here to be happy about, anything. Yeah, so anyways, I'll just leave it at that. My HON. It's in here. I use this as my writer's notebook. I am hoping to self-publish, but the way things have been going right now, I haven't written too much in the past 2.5 weeks or so. I started getting back into this. This is a daily devotional where I read a page every morning. So this has been helping me a lot the past couple of weeks. This is my traveler's notebook standard. And for this, I've been keeping track of my weight and steps. I have not been taking great care of myself. I've discovered about myself, given the past couple of weeks, that I guess just when I'm not feeling great, I don't eat a whole lot. I can't. So I did lose quite a bit of weight. But that is what it is. So the colored part is my weight, and then the non-colored part are my steps. This is where I keep all my stickers from Traveler's Notebook, the folder. So over here, I keep track of my sleep. And then my meals are over here, vitamins. You know, I've been keeping up with it. So when my husband's home on weekends, I try to eat more when my stomach is feeling up to it. Otherwise, during the week when he's at work and I'm at home by myself, I don't eat much because I just don't have an appetite. See here, I was trying to get back into the weights. Let me show you the monthly. for, so this is April. So Bruce has an appointment next week, so I need to put his sticker down for that. This is for this month. These are for classes that I've taken, his doctor appointments, and then street cleaning. I made an error right here with the highlighter, so I just put a washi tape over it. And then this was for classes that I was taking. Now this I have beside me every morning. So while I'm drinking my coffee, I generally try to set up my task for the day. And so this is functional. I only put down washi and highlighter marker, whereas with this one in my cousin, I put down a lot of stickers and washi tape. Mail I put over here. So this is for last week, and then this is my homemade paper pencil board. And these were washi tape that I purchased from JetPens a few weeks ago. Now, let's jump to my cousin. So where you saw the functional, let me do it like this. So where this is really functional in my cousin. So now you can see this is almost the end of March, and you can see how thick it's gotten. My intention when I first started the cousin back in January was to do less pictures, more drawings, but given what's been going on lately, I've been putting in more pictures. So you'll see that here in a second. So let's go to my monthly. So this is March. So the information that you see here is the same thing that you saw here in my monthly layout. Except this one is a bit more heavy, will be heavy with the stickers and or the washi tape, right? So there's my functional one, and then here's my pretty decorative one. Then we go to the weekly. So this is for this week. And this is for this week. So you can see the difference. Again, packages are over here. And this one I was feeling hopeful, optimistic for Bruce, which is why I went ahead and decorated it. I try to keep up, and then I just got into it in a good headspace towards the end of the week that I just stopped doing stuff, and I just wrote down the important things. So here, so this was last week, and then this was last week. This is the week before, and then this is the week before. And I was trying to have good vibes, so that is what my weekly layout looks like. But generally, I do it like this. I generally use this as a currently page or what I'm currently thinking of. So let me show you February. So this is my thinking about. But my whole mood for March was this dog, like this, and it just seemed to fit. And then let me just show you January really quick. Last year I was using this as a currently page, and that was kind of fun. So on Friday, March 1, selfie with my mom. These are the washi tapes I purchased from JetPens. So here we are with Bruce, it's my husband, myself, there's Bruce in the middle of the car while we were waiting at the vet. Nothing to put on this page, so I taped this down. It's the grandest entrance to the Grand Canyon. And it looked really neat. Here's Bruce. We're waiting for the results from the vet, from his biopsy. Kit Kat watching some birds in the tree. So Kit Kat is the neighborhood cat. I think he belongs to the people behind us and the people behind us on the other block. And here he is sitting at the front window waiting for me to open up the front door. So here's Bruce and Kit Kat sleeping together. So Bruce was sleeping on his side of the couch. We have a two-seater. And so Kit Kat generally sits behind me or kind of beside Bruce, but on this day he decided to sleep next to Bruce. So this is a closer up picture of that. Here's my mom's loquat. Here's Bruce with the cone of shame. So I took some pictures of Bruce beside me in bed. So he's either sleeps beside my legs, so here's my legs, or he sits kind of curled up beside me, or his head wrapped around my waist. These are two baby eagles. That's what they look like. So back at the end of January, early February, I was following the eagles from Big Bear here in California. I will link their YouTube channel, their Facebook group down below. But Jackie, the female bald eagle, she laid some eggs. The last egg she laid, her third egg, was on January 31. Before we had a big storm called the Pineapple Express. It was really cold before it arrived, so she had three eggs. They should have hatched February 29, start hatching, which was leap day. And so a lot of us were waiting with anticipation on YouTube to watch the eggs hatch. Unfortunately, they did not hatch. Nobody really knows why. You know, whether it was weather, too cold, environmental, we just don't know. And so what I did was I took a picture of these baby eagles, eaglets. So this is from the West End Bald Eagles of Catalina Island. I think they have a YouTube channel. So I will link their YouTube channel down below. This is what they look like, baby bald eagles. And they're just so cute. And I think this photo, this one's getting ready to bonk that one, B-O-N-K, which is, they kind of start fighting, showing dominance, and it's just a normal bald eagle baby behavior. It can be hard to watch because it looks painful and aggressive. So after I saw this, I stopped watching the nest. Every once in a while, I'll peek into the nest, right, going to YouTube and watching. But I generally don't watch because it's just, it's hard to watch for me. But a lot of people do watch. The mother's name is Thunder and the dad's name, they call him Chet. But I cannot pronounce the dad's name. It's A-K-E-C-H-E-T-A. There's Bruce on his flannel blanket. A selfie with me and Bruce. Me and Bruce on the couch. Again, lots of Bruce photos. This is how Bruce sleeps on my husband. So my husband took this photo of Bruce sleeping on him. Here's some more photos of Bruce. So on the 19th, this is where we took Bruce to his first oncologist visit. We wanted to get started right away if cancer was the main issue. And unfortunately, they couldn't start anything. They wanted to test him with other things. And so that's what, it was such a long drive, was so far. It was over an hour in morning traffic. And then it was worse coming back. Here we are again. And then Bruce is here, my husband, myself. And then again, more pictures of Bruce. Bruce was having a pretty decent day here. He was playing with his toys. And then here's my mom. Here's some more photos of my mom when we went to go visit her. So this was Monday. So this is where we actually saw his second oncologist, is going to be his permanent oncologist because this place is much closer to our house. So they put his name on the door. Bruce is definitely a people person dog. So there he is at the door. And then the door is there. My husband's sitting on the floor with them. And then this is the Hobonichi paper. So I put some photos so you can use it like a door like that. This was Tuesday. So we started him. It's a pill to help with his cancer. He's doing really, really good. This was yesterday, which was day two. He's still doing well. This is a photo from my back garden. I started snow peas, I think in December or January. I haven't really been paying too much attention to it, but it's grown really tall. This is probably about 6 or 7 feet tall now. So these are the flowers. The flower is, when it's purple like this, the snow pea pod will be purple. And then the white flowered one will be green. I have both growing up on the same thing. And then this, I had a tea yesterday that I purchased from Disneyland a couple of years ago. I happened to find it, and so I decided to try it. It's a black tea, and it was okay. It smells really good. It smells like apricot. So that is a look of my planners of what I did in March. My A5 HON, my cousin, and my A6 diary. If you liked the video, give it a thumbs up. If you didn't, give it a thumbs down. Subscribe if you would like to see after the pins, generally of my Hobonichi. Have a nice weekend. I'll see you in my next video. Bye.